Info Plus for genuine information.
You are welcome to my television show.
Thank you very much indeed.
Is it your first visit here in Nepal?
This is my first visit to Nepal, yes.
Okay. Did you got time to see, like, you know, some of the scenery of Nepal as well? Well,
we just had the great privilege to be shown to Bhaktapur, and that was a real treat. Mm-hmm. And it was it's a beautiful example of your heritage, mm-hmm. and your rich history, and all the craftsmanship we were able to see there. So that was a real experience.
Okay, so let me draw your attention on your, like, you know, the purpose of your visit here in Nepal. What is the purpose of your visit?
Our visit was arranged and organized by the UK-Nepal Friendship Society, mm-hmm. who take a long interest in forging relationships between Nepal and UK, and in this particular instance, between UK universities and Nepal. And our friends have arranged for Bournemouth University, which I represent here, to meet with a number of Nepalese universities in Kathmandu, mm-hmm. And to talk and explore opportunities for collaboration, mm-hmm. and future joint engagement.
Mm-hmm. What are the areas where you are trying to collaborate, or, you know, you really want to work here in Nepal?
Yes. There are several areas that we were told are of particular interest. Mm-hmm. One is around tourism, mm-hmm. In particular heritage tourism, eco-tourism, wildlife tourism, because there is a great demand in your beautiful country for that. Another area is around media and communication, mm-hmm. But also promotion and advertising, mm-hmm. of particular products, for example, in connection with tourism activities. Mm-hmm. Then interest was also raised in relation to archaeology, mm-hmm. and heritage management. Mm-hmm. Finally, on the back of an already ongoing 10-year project of one of my colleagues from health and social care, mm-hmm. There is the idea to explore collaboration in that area as well.
You visited some of the Nepalese universities as well. So,
yes.
Are they really interested to put hand together?
Yes. Well, we had talks with three universities so far. The first one was with Chibuvan, as you know, the biggest university in the country. And there are a number of areas that we talked about would be of interest. In addition to the ones I mentioned, we were also then invited to explore possibilities around climate change and, mm-hmm. conservation and biodiversity, which is new to the portfolio, but most welcome. And then we also met with the Lumbini Buddhist University and the Nepal Sanskrit University.
Okay.
So far, there are other Pokhara on the map still to come tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And we also will be in contact with a major hospital here in Kathmandu,
okay.
to talk about medical collaboration.
Would you mind to make us more clear about, you know, when do you have planned to start your collaborations here?
This is basically, first of all, a mission for exploration, mm-hmm. and for mutual acquaintance. There was a video conference held several months ago, mm-hmm. where there was first contact, if you like, between Bournemouth University and some of your institutions here in this country, mm-hmm. Which then is followed up by this visit, basically.
Mm-hmm.
We did not come here to actually sign something already,
okay.
Because we felt, you know, we just want to get to know each other, explore in all honesty and with a very clear idea of what can be done, the future prospects of collaborations,
mm-hmm.
and then we will talk later on about what exactly that format can be.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm quite confident that in the near future we will be able to talk and get on the way the first common research projects,
mm-hmm.
and exchange of staff between the universities here and Bournemouth University in
That's
the United
great.
Kingdom.
That's great. If we see the statistics of Ministry of Education here,
mm-hmm.
thousands of Nepalese youths are going abroad for quality education, and mainly they are going to UK also. What do you say about the, you know, quality education and how Nepalese universities and institutions can improve the quality so that the youths will not go abroad and they will have chance to get quality education here?
There are a number of very well established areas here in this country, so that I think your academic culture is well developed and well on its way. This is one of the reasons why we have agreed to to explore possibilities of collaboration. Your universities are in different stages of development. Some are more established and older, and others are relatively young. So we would be more than happy to share our experience and our maybe slightly more internationalized outlook with what you have to offer here, and then join forces basically to get something that is of mutual benefit and interest.
Lots of UK universities are coming here to provide degree directly.
Yes.
So do, on behalf of your university, do you have any kind of plan to provide direct degree here in Nepal?
We haven't gone that far in our talks yet, but we have a well-established system of exporting degree programs either through franchising or through validation of programs that are run in other countries, so we can basically build on a broad range of experience and our own academic history, so that I'm sure this will be part of the package we are going to look into in more detail.
What is your message to Nepalese government?
I'm maybe not in a position to advise your government, but my humble opinion would be that just concentrate on the strengths that are already there and try to combine them with experience you can obtain from outside, for example from the UK, for example from Bournemouth, to develop your skills in research, to develop skills in international publication, to make sure that Nepalese research receives the recognition it deserves.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your valuable time and information to our viewers. Thank you so much.
Great pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Info Plus. For genuine information.
दर्शकबिन अबको प्रस्तुतिमा हामीले अर्को एउटा महत्त्वपूर्ण प्रसंग जोड्न चाहिरहेका छौं। अहिले नेपाल अधिराज्यभर 3596 वटा प्लस 2 हरु सञ्चालन भइरहेका छन् र प्लस 2 मा समेत अहिले मिडियाका पढाइहरु सञ्चालन भइरहेको छ र एक तथ्याङ्क अनुसार वर्षेनी 3000 भन्दा बढी विद्यार्थीहरुले मिडिया अध्ययनलाई रोजाइमा पारेका छन् र यसै परिप्रेक्ष्यमा हामीले बेलायतको एउटा प्रसिद्ध विश्वविद्यालय जसले मिडियामा समेत अग्रणी स्थान हासिल गरिसकेको छ उक्त विश्वविद्यालयकी प्रतिनिधिलाई हामीले सोधेका थियौँ अब उक्त विश्वविद्यालयले कसरी मिडियाको पढाइहरू सञ्चालन गरिरहेको छ र नेपाली विद्यार्थीहरूले उक्त विश्वविद्यालयबाट के सिक्न सक्छन्
Bournemouth University and the media school at Bournemouth University is one of the best in the UK. It has a very, very long-standing experience in delivering media education that ranges anywhere from computer animation to media production, journalism studies and communication studies, as in public relations, advertising and marketing. So what we do at undergraduate level is what we call sandwich degrees, which means that the students would come and study with us for 2 years, and then they will have to go on a placement for 1 year, after which they will return to finish their dissertations and get their degree. This for Bournemouth University and the media school in particular has guaranteed a very, very high employability rate of our students, more than 90% of them managing to secure a job within the UK or abroad if they wish so, within 6 months from graduation.
दर्शकबिन पढाउने तौर तरिकाहरू धेरै फरक छन् बेलायत र नेपालमा र भनिए अनुसार र व्यवहारमा देखिए अनुसार के छ भने नेपालका विश्वविद्यालयहरूले खास गरी सैद्धान्तिक पढाइलाई बढी जोड दिइरहेका छन् र बेलायतका विश्वविद्यालयहरूले अथवा अन्य विकसित मुलुकका विश्वविद्यालयहरूले खास गरी व्यवहारिक शिक्षालाई बढी जोड दिइरहेका छन् यसै परिप्रेक्ष्यमा हामीले विश्वविद्यालयकी प्रतिनिधिसँग सोध्यौँ मिडिया बेलायतको युनिभर्सिटीमा कसरी पढाइ हुन्छ
There are amazing stories that we get to see every year. We work with a wide range of partners, from the BBC to computer animation studios and to some of the best known newspapers and public relations and advertising agencies around the world. Just last year, some of our students interned for the BBC. A couple of years ago, when the movie Avatar, and I'm sure you know about it, more than 50 of our students helped with the whole animation process. Some of our best students from public relations would end up working for Weber Shandwick or for Ogilvy, which are very, very big names and very big players in the communication market.
अहिले विश्व सानो गाउँमा परिणत भइसकेको अवस्थामा हामीले विभिन्न टेक्नोलोजीहरू प्रयोग गरेर विकसित मुलुकहरूले पढाउने तौर तरिका नेपालमै बसेर समेत सिक्न सक्छौँ र हामीले विश्वविद्यालयकी प्रतिनिधिसँग फेरि प्रश्न राख्यौँ, उक्त विश्वविद्यालयमा मिडिया विषय पढ्दा विद्यार्थीहरूले के फाइदा पाउन सक्छन्?
आई थिङ्क फर बोर्नमुथ युनिभर्सिटी एन्ड द मिडिया स्कुल द एडभान्टेज लाइज इन द very early on specialization of our students. So instead of getting a very generalistic degree about media, the students will learn how to do very well a job from the beginning. So they would learn public relations, they would learn advertising. Those of them, our students who would do media production, and then they would know how to do a producer's job, they would know how to do the sound editing, post editing, audio editing, radio editing. These are very, very specific jobs. For computer animation studies, our students can do what we call an art stream, which would be related to 3D computer animation, or they can do a more technical stream, which is related to visual effects and software generation. Similarly, for journalism studies, the media school has its own newspaper, has its own radio. We have our own HDTV studio. So students get very, very hands-on experience, and they get to work with the tools and with the kind of technology that they will be using in the workplace. So in a nutshell, I think our success at the media school at Bournemouth University lies exactly in that very, very applied nature of our student studies.
जाते जाते हामीले बेलायतको एउटा प्रसिद्ध विश्वविद्यालयको प्रतिनिधिलाई सोधेका थियौं, अब उक्त विश्वविद्यालयले नेपालमा मिडियासँग सम्बन्धित के कस्ता कार्यक्रमहरू अगाडि ल्याउने सोच बनाइरहेको छ। उहाँले जवाफमा यस्तो भन्नुभयो।
We have been approached by a number of universities in Nepal since our visit. Some of them raising interest or expressing interest, if you wish, into a very general media studies. I think we'll have to discuss a little bit more in depth with each and one of them to make a differentiation, as we would do back in the UK, of whether it is public relations, advertising and marketing training that we're looking into, or whether it's doing the sort of work that you do behind the camera and getting the stories out. It is very encouraging seeing young people like you, seeing everything we've seen in the past days around Kathmandu. It is very inspiring, and I think we'll have loads of experiences to share. But we are in the early stages of our discussions, and we're definitely looking forward to see what will come out of them as well.
InfoPlus, for genuine information.